So, guys and ladies.
A couple weeks ago, we got a couple of rookies get their first picks, right? That's fun.
Yeah.
Next week, you know, I think Chris got a penalty. And just what's that like coaching those guys through that high stuff and then the low stuff?
Same way that we raise our children. You have the highs and lows, and sometimes they would disappoint you, and it's disappointing to see the penalties. But yet you're so happy for the young men when they have success and with the interceptions. And so just trying to help them to just understand that you have to just play within the framework of the defense and what's called for you to do as far as the technique. But some of the plays that happen out on the field, they can be corrected. And so we have to correct them and make sure that they understand a better way to do it the next time.
Just talked about being a little bit more consistent, good plays and bad plays. From your standpoint, how is he coming along, especially now when he may have to play a bit more?
Yeah, you know, the one thing that happened with Josh when Jalen was playing, Watson was playing a lot, told Josh to stay ready. And so your time is going to come. And sure enough, it definitely came in a way that we unexpected it to come. But Josh is one of those young men who he works better when you give him more reps in practice, probably like 90% of our locker room. Once you give him more reps and they get more comfortable, they can go out and execute what we're asking them to do. And so, but I think what's going to happen with Josh, because he's played a lot of football. You guys remember when he went in the game for L.J. Snead, the Cincinnati game, after, what, 4 or 5 plays. And the kid continued to play well the rest of the Super Bowl run. So 2 years of experience, postseason, the kid has been in there, so I'm not going to skip a beat. I trust him, and I believe that he's going to do well.
Dave, what were you seeing from Chris Roland Wallace in practice that allowed you to enhance his role?
Yeah, I mean, one of the things that Chris does is you're able to tell Chris verbally what you want without necessarily having to walk through it, and he can compute it and understand and go out and perform it. And so when you find a young man who's cerebral like that, who's able to understand it not only just through walkthroughs and through reps and practice, you want to try to put that guy out on the field, because he's going to be able to see things. He's going to play with more instincts versus a guy that you're having to explain every single role, every single step. You know, they're not going to be your more instinctive guys. And so Roland is a very instinctive young man, and happy to have him.
Dave, was there a moment with him when you first got here, OTAs or camp or whenever, that you said, okay, he's not maybe our normal undrafted guy coming in here?
Yep, sure did. So when he came in, and great question, when he came in and we had him at the nickel spot / corner, and then when we moved him to the safety position, and when he had to learn the free, the strong, and the nickel, and he did it without blinking an eye, and it's one of those situations that it's just uncommon. You know, Chamari Connors had to do a little bit of nickel and safety. But when you're having to do safety, nickel, and learn corner, and that's what that young man did for us, and he was able to pick up the defense. And so learning it from the safety perspective, which I call those guys the quarterback of the defense, then down to the nickel perspective, which is a starter in the NFL, as we know, and then, of course, going out to the corners, not trying to slate them. But the young man was able to pick up and understand the techniques that we were asking him to perform. And as he was doing that, we just saw again, instinctively, he was making plays within the defense and playing with proper leverage, which helped us out.
Last one, anyone?
When you pump the Bucs passing offense on there on the tape, what do you see? What stands out about him?
I see a quarterback who is quick in his decision. He knows exactly where he wants to go with the ball. And so when you look at their offense, I mean, this is the number one third down team in the league. And that's what I stood up in front of the defense today, and I talked to everyone about that. This team is spearheaded by their quarterback. And the quarterback does a good job of getting them in and out of plays. And so, and with his legs, being able to extend plays. And so really, the offensive scheme, I think the offensive coordinator has done a great job of putting them in motions and adjustments that defense will have to make on the sideline, which can be confusing sometimes. And so, but if you can try to simplify it, if they're doing a lot, just try to simplify what you do, and hopefully, you know, guys can play faster.
Thanks, Coach.
All right, thank you. Playoff game tonight. I'm just saying.
St. James.
St. James.
St. James, thank you.
Well, Coach Heck next.
Coach Heck.
Coach Heck.